Hi, welcome to clickmyproject.com. Now let me discuss about the title of the process. The title of the process is malware reduction in cloud computing infrastructures. Now let me discuss about the objective of the process. In this paper, we discuss the reduction of anomalies using a novel detection approach that employs a one-class support vector machine that is called SBM algorithm and demonstrate the effectiveness of a detection under different anomaly types. This paper presents a cloud security solution derived from a subdomain of anomaly detection, that is called novelty detection. In this section, we firstly review the challenges arising from the virtualization embedded within cloud technologies and further discuss background related work with respect to anomaly detection in cloud environments. Now let me discuss about the abstract of our process. Cloud data centers are beginning to be used for a range of always-on services across private, public, and commercial domains. These need to be secure and resilient in the face of challenges that include cyber attacks as well as component failures and misconfigurations. However, clouds have characteristics and intrinsic internal operation structures that impact the use of traditional detection systems. Cloud services are prominent within the private and public commercial domains. Many of the services are expected to be always on and have a critical nature. Therefore, security and resilience are increasingly important aspects. In order to remain resilient, a cloud needs to possess the ability to react not only to known threats but also to new challenges that target cloud infrastructures. In this paper, we introduce and discuss an online cloud anomaly detection approach comprising dedicated detection components of our cloud resilience architecture. More specifically, we exhibit the applicability of anomaly detection and the one-class support vector machine formulation at the hypervisor level through the virtualization of features gathered at the system at network levels of cloud node. We demonstrate that our scheme can reach a high detection accuracy of over 90% whilst detecting various types of malware and DoS attacks. Furthermore, we evaluate the merits of considering not only system-level data but also network-related data depending on the attack type. Finally, the paper shows our approach to detection using dedicated monitoring components per VM is particularly applicable to cloud scenarios and leads to a flexible detection system capable of detecting new malware strains with no prior knowledge of their functionality or their underlying instructions as structure of a process. Now let me discuss about the data flow diagram of our process. In this process, we are doing data. We read the process by using data set and also real-time process. In the data set selection, first we have to select the data set. After we select the data set, we have to pre-process the data set. In the data pre-processing, we are applying a feature detection process. In this after data, we have to in the feature detection by using the data sets, we select the features in the data set and we pre-process the data set. After that, we select the attributes in that particular data set. After we collect the data set and pre-process the data set, we are going to apply the SVM one-class SVM algorithm. In this, we generate the rules based upon the SVM rule generation. After that, we generate a decision function by using the SVM parameters V and Y. After, we predict some results based upon that one. Here, we match the results with the testing data. After, we predict the intruders and normal results from that particular data set. This is a data flow diagram of our process. Now, let me discuss about the demo of our process for Yotter and Home.java. First, right click on the frame and click and fail. What I call is malware detection and cloud computing infrastructure. In this, we have two processes. One is using dataset and using real-time process. So, we first click using dataset. Here, we have to select network dataset selection. In the first, you have to select and R for dataset. That information will be displayed here. That is ID, date, time, duration, source ID, source bytes, and source ID, destination ID, flag, attack. Then, for TAR 598, here we are showing some attributes of the data set. Then after that, we enter into the feature detection process. So here, just like feature detection, so information will be displayed here. In the pre-process, the attack types will be changed into 0s and 1. Then click next button. So here, feature vectors are combined training depth for a one-class SVM formulation. So here we can identify the contextual data, then feature vectors, then click next. So here the SVM rule extraction process will be displayed here. Then parameters will be calculated here. The decision function will be calculated here. Then click next button. Based upon the particular values, here we are going to extract the information. And this is for malware rules, this is for normal rules. By using that, here we are going to extract the information. Update the rules. So based upon the rules, total rules 438 and final rules 40. Total rules 438, final rules 42. And based upon this, here we are going to classify the data. So choose the test data. In that we have a test data. So match with that particular generated data. So by using that, here we classify the normal data and intuition data. And click next. So by using that information, here we are calculating the receiver operating access of SVM. So here we are calculating, estimating the true positive rate, false positive rate, and false negative rate. By using that information, we calculate the accuracy. By using this information, here we evaluate the performance of proposed system by using true false positive rate, true negative rate, and by using that ROC. This is by using data set. Now let me discuss about by using a real-time process. So browse file to send. We can choose any file. So generate signature for this file, then send to forwarder. So run forwarder node.java. So here you need to enter password. Generate and receive that particular information. Here you have to verify and send to that particular information. No valves are detected. That information will be sent to that receiver. So run receiver.java. Here you need to enter again that password. If you enter that password as a wrong means, and that signatures will be defer. So by using the signature, here we are verifying. If the signature is defer means that file will be exit due to the malware identified. So verify and send. Malware detected. That is a strong, our password is a strong password. Okay, the system will be exit. So this is a complete demo of process. Thank you for watching.